Cleome Gynandra belongs to the family Caparaceae. It is commonly known as spider plant. It is a wild vegetable commonly eaten by the people of the Eastern Cape. It grows to a height of about 1.5 meters. The whole part of this plant has been implicated in herbal medicine for the treatment of several diseases such as malaria, epileptic fits, trauma, amongst others. The plant is well known for its antioxidant properties. The production of free radicals, particularly reactive oxygen species, have been known to have a major impact on humans, both from within the body and from the environment. Reactive oxygen species such as superoxide anion, hydrogen peroxide, hydroxyl peroxide, hydroxyl ion, and hydroxyl radicals are generated during metabolic processes. As such, they cause deterioration to lipid cells, DNA, and immune systems, and also to essential proteins. They are also known to cause oxidative stress, leading to the pathogenesis of several diseases, such as diabetes, cancer, chronic inflammation, atherosclerosis, and so on. However, some of these radicals can be eliminated naturally or by synthetic antioxidant agents. Such synthetic antioxidant agents include butylated hydroxyl toluene, butylated hydroxyl anisole, BHT, garlic acid, rutin, and vitamin C. Again, some of these synthetic agents have been known to have adverse effects on living cells. In addition to that, they are also inaccessible and they are expensive. Now, having said all this, the interest in natural antioxidants have increased. The interest in natural antioxidants from natural sources have increased in recent times. Despite this upsurge interest, there is still lack of scientific reports on the significance of its phytochemicals and antioxidant properties. Therefore, this study was carried out to evaluate quantitatively the phytochemicals and antioxidant properties of acetone extract of Cleome Gynandra in order to add to our knowledge of its ethno-medicinal use. Doing that, we collected fresh leaves, fruits, and stems. Different parts of the plants were collected from the University of Fort Hare Research Farm in Alice. And then the samples were properly washed with distilled water, oven dried at 30 degrees Celsius to a constant weight, pulverized to fine powder, and stored in airtight bottles. 200 grams of each plant part was extracted separately in acetone for 48 hours under mechanical agitation. The extracts were then filtered and evaporated to dryness under reduced pressure at 40 degrees Celsius. The following phytochemical constituents were analyzed for. The total phenolic content in the extract were determined by the modified falling temperature method, while the flavonoid content was determined by the method used by Otola et al. The flavonol content was determined by the method based on the method used by Olajuwon et al. And the rest as seen on the slide. The alkali content was also determined according to the method of Oyinaga and Islam. The saponin content in the plant was also determined. And then the following antioxidant acids were determined using the following methods. Now, having said all that, our findings revealed that the leaf. The leaf had the highest concentration of total phenols, total flavonols, and total flavanols. While it showed a different trend in the total pro-anthocyanidin content, where the stem extract had the highest concentration of pro-anthocyanidin. Although the leaf extract showed a considerable amount of total pro-anthocyanidin. Going to the tannin content, it was really relatively low in all plant parts. It's you can't really see anything there, but then it's there, but it's very low. And then the alkaloids are also relatively low, and there was no significant difference between the plant parts evaluated for. And also, a similar trend was also observed in the saccharine context. Now, despite this low concentration of tannins, it can still contribute significantly to the body. As we all know, that tannins play a major role in the treatment of inflamed tissues and also the prevention of cancer. Now, the high concentration of flavonols, and proanthocyanidin and flavonols and phenols act as biological substances that inhibit diseases and are sort of serve as defense mechanism in humans. They are also known to have various pharmacological and biological activities such as anti-inflammatory, immune modulatory, and anti-allergic properties, which reduce the risk of cardiovascular mortality. They are also essential to scavenge free radicals because they are able to scavenge the hydroxyl group, quench these free radicals, and also decompose peroxide. Proanthocyanidin, as we saw in the other slide, the slide I just showed, was high in this plant, especially in the stem, and it has been reported that proanthocyanidin reduces the risk of cardiovascular diseases, cancer, and also improve blood circulation by strengthening the blood capillaries. Tannins also play a major role, which I said earlier. And then alkaloids and saponins are known to have ethno-pharmacological uses. As we know, alkaloid acts as agents they have analgesic properties and anti-plasmodic properties, while saponin acts as antifungal agents. The results of the antioxidant assay, here the reducing capability of the plant extract, of the various plant extracts. As you can see here, the highest reducing capability of the plant extract was significantly higher than the standards used in the study. The standards were rutin and vitamin C. These are our plant extract. The stem extract exhibited, at the lowest concentration, the stem extract exhibited the highest ferric reducing ability. This was followed by the fruit, and then this was in the leaf. The observed reductive potential of the extract is as a result of the presence of hydrophilic polyphenolic contents, which I mentioned earlier. We have the flavonols, the proanthocyanidin, and the total phenols. Figure 3 shows us the nutric oxide scavenging activity of Cleome Gynandra. Here, a different trend was observed. The standards used in this study were significantly higher than those of the plant extracts. Routine showed the highest inhibited the nutric oxide at 0.5. The level of nutric oxide radical was significantly reduced by the plant extract as a result of the scavenging ability of the extract. This could be related to the presence of flavonols, which are able to compete with oxygen, thus inhibiting the anions to form, which are formed. Nitric oxide plays a vital role in the pathogenesis of several diseases associated with inflammation in humans. Figure 4 shows us the ABTS radical scavenging activity of Cleome Gynandra. The scavenging activity of the various extracts against ABTS radical was found to be higher in the leaf when compared to the stem and the fruit. Here again, the standards were significantly higher than the plant extracts. All plant parts exhibited their highest concentration at all plant parts exhibited their highest inhibition at a concentration of 0.5 mg per mil, which could imply that the scavenging ability of the plant is dose dependent. The scavenging activities of the various extracts against DPPH radical scavenging activities shows they were dose dependent, and also the stem here showed the highest scavenging activity among the plant parts determined. Although, when comparing the plant parts and the standards used in this study, the standards were significantly higher than that of the plant parts evaluated for. The result of the DPPH was more or less similar to that of the ABTS assay. The IC50 scavenging activities of Cleome Gynandra was also determined of the various plant parts, and these are the values we obtained. I would like to say that the IC50, a lower IC50 value, does when obtained, signifies a higher scavenging activities of the plant extract. For instance, we could see here that 0.2, we notice that our activity for most standards were rutin and vitamin C. They exhibited the highest scavenging abilities for most of the acids evaluated for, except for the ferric reducing ability, where the plant parts exhibited the highest scavenging abilities. Now, in conclusion, the study revealed that different parts of Cleome Gynandra contain substantial amounts of phenolics, proanthocyanidin, and flavonoids. These constituents have been variously reported to be responsible for antioxidant properties. Therefore, this plant, also a wild vegetable, has good pharmacological properties in addition to its nutritional values. I'd like to acknowledge Governor Becky Research and Development Center for funding this project, and also Medicinal Plants and Economic Development Research Center for affording me this opportunity to be here. Thank you.